Assalamualaikum and hi everyone. My name is Ilani Dayana Bintino Arsman and I grew with Fatima Bintino Zam. We represent for group project programming for data science. Okay, for introduction, this analysis is focused on the behavior of bank customers who are more likely to close their account according to the other customer historical data. For data set, we get it from the Kaggle. Okay, for the problem statement, has three main problem statements, which is: is there any significant difference between customer age and income category? Is there any relationship exists between income category and education level? Third, which classification algorithm performance in the customer trend prediction has a better accuracy? For the objective is to determine if there any significant difference between customer age and income category. Second is to determine the real relationship between income category and education level. Third is to conduct the customer trend prediction by using regression and classification algorithms such as classification tree and extreme gradient boosting.
Hi, my name is Fatima, and I will start my presentation with the introduction to the data set. So there are about 10,137 rows and about 23 columns of features in the data set that we have chosen. So here are some of the features that are in our data set. And the first thing that we did is that we performed the data extraction and also the data cleaning. And in the data cleaning process, we remove the features that are not necessary or not useful for our data analysis. And we convert the necessary features to factors. And we also remove the missing or the null values. So this is the result. So we have about seven features or columns that are being considered for our data analysis. So after that, we perform the EDA. So in EDA process, we have seen or observed that the existing customers are larger than the treated or churning customers. And in the continuous variable distribution, there are three variable features that we considered, which are the credit limit, customer age, and also the months on book. Months on book is about the highest period of relationship between the customer and also the bank. So we can see in the chunk limit graph, we can see that it is skewed to the right. So there are many outliers which are around 30,000. And we can see that for the customer age, it's almost having a normal distribution. And for the months on book, we can see that the highest period of relationship for the customer with the bank would be around 35 months. So next, what we did is that we do the correlation, and we can see that months on book has a high correlation with the customer age, and this is an example of multicollinear. And for the category variable, we have considered card category, gender, education level, and also income category for the distribution, and we can see that most of the customers purchase blue card from the bank, and we can see that the customers are mostly females rather than males. And most of them has education level until graduate. And the income category for the customers the highest are less than $40,000. So next, what we did is we do the modeling. So in the modeling, we split the data set to train and test data, and 70% of them are considered as trained data, and the others are concluded as the test data.
Okay, next is regression. The glimpse is to see every column in data frame by transform versions. Right now we have 8 columns and this is number of rows. Next we select the certain variables are needed from the bank data, which is attrition flag, customer age, gender, education level, income category, and card category. Okay, right now the output shows we have 6 columns and this is number of rows. To double check the variable are needed by using structured bank data, this is the variable we are select from the above. Next is to determine if there any significant difference between customer age and income category by using ANOVA. The reason we are using ANOVA is because we have one categorical variable which is income category and one numeric variable which is customer age. this is the output we get from the ANOVA. By using hypothesis test for HashNAS, there is no significant difference between customer age and income category. For H1, there is significant difference between customer age and income category. Next, the p-value we get is, we compute with the alpha. The result shows p-value is less than alpha. So we reject HashNAS. For conclusion, at alpha 0.05, there is enough evidence to reject HashNAS. Therefore, there is significant difference between customer age and income category. Next, we plot by using box plot. For X axis is customer age and Y axis is income category. The result shows we have 4 outliers here for income category less than 40k, 40k until 60k, and 2 outliers for 120k and more. The for income category 60k until 80k and 40k until 60k, we can indicate is for it has a normal skewness because the median is in the center line. Next is plot for normality between customer age and income category. Okay, the 2 is for the normal QQ. The result shows has 3 outliers which are at 152, 252, and 255. Okay, next is to determine the relationship between income category and education level by using chi-square test. The Pearson chi-square test is used for parametric data that we get from the normal QQ. Okay, chi-square test is we want to compute for both categorical, which is income category and education level. So by using hypothesis test, for HashNAS, there is no relationship exists between income category and education level, which is independent. For H1, there is a relationship exists between income category and education level, which is dependent. For the p-value we get from the output, which is 0.03655, is less than alpha 0.05. Then we reject HashNAS. For conclusion, at alpha 0.05, there is enough evidence to reject HashNAS. Therefore, there is a relationship exists between income category and education level, which is dependent. Next, we visualize by using bar graph. For the education level, the guard rate and income category for less than 40k shows have the highest and most credit card holder customer.
So I will continue my presentation with the classification process. So in classification, we use two algorithms, which is the decision tree and also the extreme gradient boosting. So for the decision tree, it splits the data until a decision is made. And here is the result for the confusion matrix. We can see the value of its accuracy and also its kappa value. So the next algorithm, we use the extreme gradient boosting. So extreme gradient boosting is a prediction model in the form of an assemble of weak algorithms or such as decision tree. So the reason why we chose these two types of algorithms is that it is easier for us to compare the performance and also the accuracy for both algorithms. And we can see that its accuracy and kappa value is higher than the decision tree. So this is the comparison for the model performance. We can see that the classification tree has a lower ROC curve than to the extreme gradient boosting. So the next one is that we did a comparison table. We can see that the accuracy of the extreme gradient boosting is 0.85, which is higher than the classification tree. And for the F measure, the extreme gradient boosting is performing better than the classification tree. And for the kappa value, the extreme gradient boosting is 0.16 higher than the classification tree. And for the AUC, we can see that for the extreme gradient boosting is around 0.78. So which means that it is 78, it has a 78 chances that it can distinguish between the positive and also the negative classes. While for classification tree, it has a very slight chance because it is, it has the AUC curve around 0.57. So here are the conclusion. We use the we perform regression by using ANOVA and chi square test. And for the classification, we use extreme gradient boosting and also classification tree. For future work, we will be implementing more machine learning algorithms. Thank you.